The crankcase on your engine has a one-way valve that directs any excess air pressure back into the intake. So that way, any oil or gas vapors that are in your engine can be safely burnt off through the process of combustion. The problem is that sometimes these vapors can liquefy in this process, leaving liquid oil in your intake that can go to gunk up sensors, dirty your intake valves, and hinder your general performance. This is especially bad on direct injection cars like the FA20 WRX because there's no gasoline spraying on the top of the valves to clean them off of this oil. WRXs like this can benefit from having two oil catch cans, one on the positive crankcase ventilation line and one on the crankcase ventilation line. While on a track car, you would definitely want to have both oil catch cans, or better yet, you would want to cash out for an air oil separator that actually drains that oil back into your sump. On a street car, you really only need a catch can on the PCV line. There's plenty of people with street cars who have installed both cans. The one on the CCV line is almost always dry, but the one on the PCV line catches plenty of oil. What I have here is a cheap, universal $25 catch can. The build quality is actually very good. It does have baffling on the inside, though rather minimal. It's designed to be filled with steel wool that can be used to help trap the oil and condense it back to a liquid. It comes with various size fittings, a simple bracket, but the really cool feature is that it actually has its own little dipstick. This thing also came with a rather cheap rubber hose and hose clamps. I am going to be replacing those with some nice silicone hoses and some more quality hose clamps. There are plenty of catch can options for the WRX that are plug and play, but these also cost a lot more money. Now, they will come with the right hoses, the right hose clamps, everything you need for a bolt-on plug-and-play application. At the end of the day, having some sort of a catch can is better than nothing, because any catch can on the PCV line is going to be capturing oil. To install the PCV hose catch can, begin by removing the engine cover. Remove the intercooler bracket bolts. Loosen the inlet and outlet hose clamps and remove the intercooler. Here is the factory PCV vent line, which I am removing and replacing with 10 millimeter inner diameter silicone hoses. I was able to get the hose to disconnect from the intake manifold without too much trouble and pull it off. And now I'm to the point where I can spin it around. Down there is where you have your actual PCV valve that connects to the crankcase. Problem is, the end of that has a little flange barb thing on it, so I can't just easily pull the hose off. I know that I'm going to be replacing this hose and I'm not going to be putting it back on there, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down here and try to cut the edge of the hose, and that way it should come off a lot easier. So I just realized that the inlet to the intake manifold is a little bit larger than the side that connects to the crankcase. But I had a 10 millimeter inner diameter silicone hose that without any trouble at all was able to fit over both of these. Just a little bit of stretching and I was able to make it fit on the intake side. I did have to build a custom bracket for my catch can, which I bolted here to the side of the intake box. I put it here for ease of access and the simplest way to route the hoses. With the catch can mounted, the in line should be connected to the engine block and the out line should connect to the intake manifold. Be sure to check the level of your oil catch can regularly. Empty it with every oil change or more frequently if necessary.